We're also looking at being a part of a very innovative project called Job Redesign, where we look at taking the most effective teachers and leveraging them across more students. So we take the best teachers that we have in these 8 schools, and instead of those teachers just teaching 25 kids, that teacher may have the opportunity to teach 50 or 75 kids. Now, some of you may say, well, how in the world are you going to do that? There's a whole plan on how to do that, but I can tell you that person will not take roll, walk kids to lunch, walk kids to the buses. Essentially, what that person does all day is creates a great power lesson, excellent lesson, what they do every day with their own 25 kids, and they just push into a classroom and co-teach with maybe a novice teacher or a teacher that hasn't met that master level. And then they go on to the next classroom and they do the same lesson with another teacher. So that person, you're taking some of the administrative duties off of their shoulders, and they essentially focus on high quality teaching and learning. So we're looking at that as an option. One of the things the teachers have been very excited about is a summer LIFT institute. We know that teachers right now, they're off during the summer, but what many people don't know is that they're not off, because they're often at home and at Panera Bread and wherever they can be planning and writing lesson plans for the school year if they don't get paid to do that. So my goal is to bring teachers back a month early, pay them for an 11-month work year, and give them the opportunity to not only get professional development, but also have the opportunity to sit with their colleagues and plan for the year, and not wait till the kids come back and everything starts happening and then you're trying to write a lesson plan. Essentially, when the kids show up, teachers could be planning for the entire school year, and they're just meeting to tweak their lesson plans. The teachers have been very excited about that, as I have visited schools to discuss this with them. We're also looking at effective recruitment and selection processes, a compensation strategy, because we're going to raise the standard. So how are we going to get people to stay and stay on board? Look at how we're going to remove low performers in a more aggressive manner. Right now, if you're a teacher and you have career status, you're pretty much guaranteed a job for life. And to me, that's unacceptable. So we're looking at how we might be able to work around that. And then you see some of the policy reform efforts that we're looking at the state level. So with that said, I'm going to stop and let you all react to the talent category of the plan.